Second, in our liturgy, we are observing the solemnity of our Lord Jesus Christ, King of the universe. This is the last Sunday of the current liturgical year. We welcome everyone, especially all visitors, to Our Lady of Mount Carmel Church. Now, would you please stand at the beginning of Mass?
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Brothers, sisters, good to have you for Mass, and thanks everybody for your patience with our, shall we say, constricted accommodations. We're not allowed inside anymore, but there you have it. Nonetheless, we make do, and it's a treat to have you all here. Thank you for making the effort to come. Let's come into the Lord's presence, remembering our many blessings, God's love in our lives, and His strength for this day and the week ahead. Lord Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary. Lord, have mercy. You are the Word made flesh and dwelling among us. Christ, have mercy. You are King and Author of our life. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life. Glory be to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, whose will is to restore all things in your beloved Son, the King of the universe, grant, we pray, that the whole creation, set free from slavery, may render your majesty service, and ceaselessly proclaim your praise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord God, I myself will look after and tend my sheep. As a shepherd tends his flock when he finds himself among his scattered sheep, so will I tend my sheep. I will rescue them from every place where they were scattered when it was cloudy and dark. I myself will pasture my sheep. I myself will give them rest, says the Lord God. The lost I will seek out, the strayed I will bring back. The injured I will bind up, the sick I will heal. But the sleek and the strong, I will destroy, shepherding them rightly. As for you, my sheep, says the Lord God. I will judge between one sheep and another, between rams and goats. The word of the Lord. The responsorial psalm. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. In the verdant pastures, he gives me repose. The Lord is my shepherd. Beside restful waters, he leads me. He refreshes my soul. He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since death came through man, the resurrection of the dead came also through man. For just as in Adam all die, so too in Christ shall all be brought to life. But each one in proper order. Christ, the first fruits. Then, at his coming, those who belong to Christ. Then comes the end, when he hands over the kingdom to his God and Father, when he has destroyed every sovereignty and every authority and power. For he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed is death. When everything is subjected to him, then the Son himself will also be subjected to the one who subjected everything to him, so that God may be all in all. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said to his disciples, when the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the angels with him, he will sit upon his glorious throne, and the nations will be assembled before him, and he will separate them, one from another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. He will place a sheep on his right, and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right, come, you who are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. A stranger, and you welcomed me. Naked, and you clothed me. Ill, and you cared for me. In prison, and you visited me. Then the righteous will answer him and say, Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? When did we see you a stranger and welcome you, or naked and clothe you? When did we see you ill or in prison and visit you? And the king will say to them in reply, amen, amen, I say to you, whatever you did for one of the least brothers of mine, you did for me. Then he will say to those on his left, depart from me, you accursed, into the eternal fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, and you gave me no food. I was thirsty, and you gave me no drink. A stranger, and you gave me no welcome. Naked, and you gave me no clothing. Ill and in prison, and you did not care for me. And they will answer, Lord, when did we see you hungry or thirsty, or a stranger or naked or ill or in prison, and not minister to your needs? You will answer them, Amen, I say to you, what you did not do for one of these least ones, you did not do for me. And those will go off to eternal punishment, but the righteous to eternal life. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated if you're able to. Those who can't, God bless you. Appreciate your patience. You're getting extra credit today. One of the reasons why I like watching YouTube to wind down my day is that there's a lot of great history programs that are there. And I was watching one the other night that was talking about a moment in history back in the 1950s called the Kitchen Debate. Do you remember this? It was during the Eisenhower years, and Richard Nixon was vice president under Eisenhower, and Khrushchev of Russia came to the United States on kind of a diplomacy and a publicity tour, a breaking of the ice of the for a moment in the Cold War, and it got an awful lot of press all over the world. And Richard Nixon was kind of tasked with babysitting this guy who had a eccentric fellow. Remember, he was the one who took his shoe off and banged it on the podium in front of the United Nations General Assembly in an hour's long rant. Going like this, and you might see if you're a history, a Disney fanatic, you know that Khrushchev even got a tour of Disneyland, I think even before it was open, but right around that time. And one of the things that Khrushchev did when he was visiting the Iowa State Fair that had a display of a new modern kitchen, and it was the pride of, I don't know, Electrolux or General Electric or Frigidaire or somebody like that. But it was just showing off the new technology and the new styling and the snazzy colors and yada yada. And they got into an argument. Nixon was pointing his finger at him like this, and Khrushchev was arguing back about the advantages of one system of communism versus American free enterprise and liberty. It got into a long, long conversation between the two, at times even heated. Khrushchev said, your children, your grandchildren, will live under communism one day. Nixon replied, your grandchildren will be free one day. Nixon got that one right. Many of us were privileged to get to see that moment when a bloody empire that required gulags to keep people behaved and an iron wall around Berlin to keep them in crumbled without much bloodshed. And to recall that ought to be encouraging to us. Nixon was able to see the longer view. Today, the Feast of Christ the King invites us to a longer view. Another example is this one. The other day I was at a Holy Sepulchre for a gravesite. Not one of our parishioners, but a friend's invited me to come and help out. He was a Cuban exile. As a young man, swam for 8 hours alone to flee that island before he was rescued. Came to the States, became the father of a very fine family, a machinist and a shop owner, making aerospace products that keep us safe and flying through the air. Passed away, and in very small and quiet circumstances of today, we were able to gather out there at Holy Sepulchre. Beautiful, beautiful 11 o'clock in the morning. Weather was lovely, and the grave pointed to the hills. It was set up on a bit of a rise, so you could see the wash down below. Beautiful big thing as part of Irvine Park, and the hills in the distance. And I said, look, boys and girls, this very grave, his toes, where we're planting them, points to the east. to the direction of the rising sun, to that beautiful image of Christian architecture, and even the way we arrange our cemeteries from ancient custom, that even a grave would point to the long view, would point to the east, to the dawning sun, to that eternal day, the shouts of angels and the blast of trumpets, and the coming of our Lord of life and new life. Christ the King invites us to that long view. Maybe in our nerdy politics these days, it's a little difficult to imagine that kind of a reign. But the feast invites us to something that we desperately can use these days. And that's the long view. The view that our Lord of life is a shepherd of souls, is one who loves, a charity that's hands-on, and invites us to be grateful for that love and to model it ourselves. Happy feast day, everyone. Happy end of the liturgical year, and next weekend we begin Advent, and it's good to be able to pray with you this fine day. Do you renounce Satan and all his empty works and all his empty show? Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, born of the Virgin Mary, crucified, died and was buried, rose from the dead, and seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? This, dear friends, is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We proudly profess in Christ Jesus, our Lord. With confidence, let's bring our prayers to God.
For Pope Francis, our own Bishop Kevin, his brother bishops, and all leaders of the Church. In all their decisions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For decision makers in government, that they may work in unison for peace and justice, respect religious freedom, and honor the dignity of all human life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the hungry, that they may be fed. For the homeless, that they may find shelter. For the lonely, that they may be comforted. For those in prison, may they know true freedom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For each of us, as we struggle to live as faithful disciples, that we may carry out the gospel message and see the face of Jesus in all our brothers and sisters, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all in our parish family who are sick and in need of healing, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, that they may inherit the kingdom of heaven in all its glory, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And we offer the Master, Dr. Don Christensen, for his rest in peace. We pray to the Lord. Heavenly Father, hear the voices of your children in prayer. May we look to you, our Lord and life, through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the bread we offer you, which earth has given and human hands have made, it become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, goodness we receive the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and the work of human hands that will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church, as we offer you, Lord, the sacrifice by which the human race is reconciled to you. We humbly pray that your Son himself may bestow on all nations the gifts of unity and peace through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you anointed your only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, with the oil of gladness as eternal priest and King of all creation, so that by offering himself on the altar of the cross as a spotless sacrifice to bring us peace, he might accomplish the mysteries of human redemption, making all created things subject to his rule. He might present to the immensity of your majesty an eternal kingdom of an eternal and universal kingdom, a kingdom of truth and life, a kingdom of holiness and grace, a kingdom of justice, love, and peace. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Kevin, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who please you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with
the Holy Spirit. All glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
As the Lord himself taught us, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer one another a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be.
Thank you.
immortality. We ask, O Lord, that glory and in obedience to the commands of Christ, the King of the universe, we may live with him eternally in his heavenly kingdom, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. A couple of brief announcements before we go, if you please.
This Monday, the 23rd, is our normal day of Eucharistic adoration. Given current COVID restrictions, the Blessed Sacrament will be on exhibition in the courtyard immediately following the 8 a.m. morning mass until 9 a.m. Thursday, Thanksgiving Day, all are invited to our special Mass of Thanksgiving celebrated at 9 a.m. Please bring along the bread or wine that will be served with your Thanksgiving food to be blessed. The collection will benefit Mercy House Outreach to the Homeless. Last weekend, through your generosity, all of our listed families in need were matched up in this year's Adopt a Family for Christmas program. However, if anyone is still interested in helping with the program, you may contact Rochelle Lowry, whose phone number and email are in the bulletin. Volunteers are needed after Mass. Please help sanitize the chairs for the next Mass. Thank you. Please take a bulletin home as you leave today. Extra copies may be found on the table near the sacristy's door.
A lot of hard work goes into getting our Mass ready and our place hospitable. Thanks to everyone and all of you for making the effort to join us. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and to serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Those who want to help out the Msgr Club, we have large different food towel and drug to be corrupted. Oh, thank you. You're here. You did it.